an extraordinary ruling at the High Court, where a father known as Arb lost his damages claim against an IVF clinic in London over forged consent forms, has placed a spotlight on the need for absolute clarity when seeking fertility treatment of any kind. The case has already forced many IVF clinics around the country, including IVF Hammersmith, where the couple in question had their treatment, to change their practices surrounding consent forms. Many clinics now insist on the signing of contracts in the clinic itself, or Skype calls to witness the signing of contracts, if parents are abroad. Despite the judge concluding that Arb did not sign the consent to thaw form at all, that his signature was forged by R, the mother, and that IVF Hammersmith owed a strict contractual obligation to Arb to obtain his written consent to the procedure, he lost his claim for damages against the clinic. The claim failed due to public policy, which stipulates that parents cannot be compensated for the birth of a healthy child. The judge, Mr. Justice J., held that the principles underpinning two House of Lords decisions in NHS claims given some 15 years ago apply equally to this contractual claim for damages against IVF Hammersmith and Rees v. Darlington Memorial Hospital NHS Trust 2004. The situation was slightly different, in that the mother was disabled and underwent a sterilization procedure because she feared that her blindness would prevent her from looking after any child. The procedure was negligently performed. The House of Lords, reversing the Court of Appeal, held that the mother could not recover damages for any of the costs of providing for the child, although there would be a conventional award of £15,000 to reflect the fact that she was the victim of a legal wrong. In McFarlane v. Tayside Health Board 2000, the House of Lords held that a claim brought by parents for the upkeep of a healthy child born after negligence in connection with a vasectomy procedure could not be sustained in law. Measuring the loss, looking again at Rees, Mr. Justice J. said the legal policy objections may be characterized as follows: the inherent difficulty, if not impossibility, of measuring the loss, the unwillingness to regard the child as a financial liability, the refusal to offset the benefits which will accrue from parenthood from any additional financial liabilities, the feeling that it is morally unacceptable to attempt this exercise, and the notion that it is not fair, just and reasonable to allow this sort of claim. Arb's legal team argued that the facts of his case were unique. He is an unwanted child, born in extremely fraught, possibly unique, circumstances. Arb has been deceived by R and let down by the clinic. However, stepping back from the facts of this case, I do not believe that Arb is able to distinguish Rees, Mr. Justice J. said. I have no reason to believe that Ms. Rees did not love her child, but she did not want him. Arb has suffered a legal wrong, but so did Ms. Rees, more profound in her case, because a relatively straightforward procedure was ineptly performed. The fact that Arb feels conflicted, and Ms. Rees probably does not, is not an important distinction. Paradoxically, Arb's claim against the clinic would have greater legal merit if he had refused to provide for his daughter, but the family court had so ordered. In my judgment, Ms. Rees and Arb find themselves for these present purposes in like case. The father plans to appeal against the decision regarding damages in the Supreme Court.